In 1981, the singer Frank Sinatra sought a license to become entertainments consultant to Caesar's Palace Hotel, the most famous of all Las Vegas casinos. Public interest was so great that local television stations covered the hearings. Sinatra faced questions about his alleged friendship over the years with notorious mobsters from New York and Chicago.
Ms. Sinatra, would you raise your hand to be sworn, please?
Sinatra had to answer questions about his relationship with Sam Giancana. Giancana, once a gunman for Al Capone, became boss of the Chicago crime family and its gambling rackets in 1959. He loved beautiful women, like the singer Phyllis McGuire. Giancana was also a friend of Frank Sinatra's. The Gaming Commission wanted to know about an incident in 1962 when Giancana was staying at Frank Sinatra's casino.
I had a telephone call at about 1 o'clock in the morning, and I was home in Los Angeles from Eddie King, who was one of our employees. And he said to me, Giancana's here visiting his lady, and we just broke up a hell of a fight in the bungalow. And at that point is when I said to him, separately from Mr. Rudin's statement, I said to him, get him off the property. Just get rid of him.
That's good testimony. Did you know that, or was the reason you said that, the knowledge that this guy wasn't undesirable and could be getting you into trouble?
Of course.
Giancana was welcome at Frank Sinatra's show business parties, and at one of these he met Judith Exner. Judith Exner had been the lover of Sinatra. She would become the lover of President Kennedy and Sam Giancana. She met them both through Frank Sinatra.
Frank had gotten his group together in the early 60s and put a show on in Las Vegas with Dean Martin, Peter Lawford, Joey Bishop, Sammy Davis, and Frank. And they were making a picture there at the time, Ocean's 11. Well, the show was such a success that they took the show to Florida. When they went down there, I had been in New York, and I went down. I was invited to attend a party that they were going to have, and I wanted to see the show. And I went down with some friends of mine. It was at this party for the closing night. There probably were 500 people there, but I was introduced to Sam Giancana by Frank Sinatra that night. Sam had known Frank for many, many years. Part of the respect that Frank gets is because of his known relationship with these men.
The Westchester Premier Theatre in the suburbs of New York. In the 1970s, Frank Sinatra made 3 week-long appearances at the theater, which was run by New York organized crime figures. They exploited Frank Sinatra's shows in a $9 million mafia fraud. The theater went bankrupt, and 7 mobsters were sent to jail. One of them was Louis Pasella, also known as Louis Dome or Dones.
Mr. Sinatra, do you know a Mr. Louis Pasella?
Yes, very well.
Would you describe him as a good friend?
That's right.
Did he ever discuss with you appearing at the Westchester Theater?
Yes, he was the first man to invite me to perform at the theater. And I asked him some questions about what it seated, what type of building it was. Was it in the round or was it on stage and so on and so forth. And he explained it to me and I said, well, we'll see what we can do about it. And I think in subsequent months, we found the calendar to be open. And then I think Mr. Rudin took charge and made the deal.
Is he the type of gentleman, or did he have a type of background that one might be aware of?
I know what you're saying, Mr. Chairman, but I can't attest to that because I've never been present when... If he had any form of activity, I'd never been present. He had a restaurant in New York, and I visited very often. I liked it. It was good food, and I became fond of him, and that was the extent of my friendship with him.
Okay. And you were aware, undoubtedly, that at some point in that Westchester incident, he was convicted of...
Yes, I'm well aware.
...of not reporting some of the income
yes,
that he
I'm
received.
Yes, I'm well aware.
Sinatra got there through Louis Dones. Louis Dones went to the Westchester Theater, says, look, I can get you Sinatra, but I got to get a piece of the proposition. So they went along with it. So Sinatra, when he got there, Louis Dones used to run it. Everything. He got a piece of the scalping. He got a piece of the T-shirts. He got a piece of everything. See, Louis Dones is a made guy with the Genovese family. Now, Louis Dones went to the grand jury and refused to talk about Sinatra. And he did like 14 months for it. So, you know, there's something he could say and he don't want to say.
This photograph was taken backstage at the Westchester Theater in 1976 after Sinatra's performance. Sinatra is surrounded by leaders of the Mafia, including Carlo Gambino, the most powerful crime boss in America, his underboss, Paul Castellano, and Los Angeles boss, Jimmy the Weasel Fratiano.
I was asked by one of the members of the theater who he was. It doesn't come to me. I don't think it's that important. He told me that Mr. Gambino had arrived with his granddaughter, whose name, perchance, happened to be Sinatra, and he said they would like to take a picture, and I said, fine. They came in, and I took a picture of the little girl. And before I realized what happened, there were approximately 8 or 9 men standing around me. That is the whole incident that took place.
Did you have any acquaintance with Mr. Gambino prior to that? Had you ever met him?
No, I never did. Not before nor after that.
Okay. Did you have any information about any of the people that were in that photograph with you? Did you know any of them by sight?
Well, Mr. Marzen, I think, was in the picture, whom I knew, because he was one of the owners of the club, and I knew him. And I later found out that I was introduced to somebody named Jimmy, and I later found out it was this Fink the Weasel, so I didn't know him at the time.
Jimmy Fratiano.
Yeah.
Subsequently, did you have an opportunity after this picture received some degree of notoriety to learn what the background was of some of those people?
No.
That you were there?
No.
As of today, you do not know what some of the background...
I didn't even know their names, let alone their backgrounds. I didn't even know most of the names.
I mean, subsequent to that, in the last little while.
No. No, I haven't. Nobody's asked me about it, and nobody's... I haven't discussed it with anybody.
Well, certainly, all of the people in that picture, save and excepting yourself, and it is quite a who's who of what's what, I guess, in the area of organized crime.
I wish that we didn't have to discuss Mr. Fratiano, because he's a confessed murderer, a perjurer, and I would rather not discuss him involved with my own life.
Well, Mr. Sinatra,
that's a fair enough question.
Yes, unfortunately, I can appreciate what you're saying, but it is in the public record, and Mr. Fratiano has received a great deal of acclaim as a very creditable witness.
He made a statement that he was going to take a picture with somebody's niece. This is the last picture we took in Westchester. And he says all of a sudden, 8 men were around him. Well, that's a lot of baloney. He wanted to take a picture with Gambino, and he offered Gambino to come in the back. He wanted to meet him. And he goes to the gaming board and, you know, he just lied about these things, eh?
Can he possibly claim he doesn't know who's in it with him?
Well, that's what he said. He didn't know who was there. You know he's lying. You know, what do you mean he don't know who they are? He knows who they are. All he says is 8 people gagged around him, took a picture. He was going to take a picture with somebody's niece. He's lying.
Gentlemen and ladies of the commission, an aye vote on this vote would give Frank Sinatra an unlimited license in the state of Nevada. Please call the roll.
Mr. Walsh?
Aye.
Ms. Stelter?
Aye.
Mr. Ings?
Aye.
Mr. Dodge?
No.
Mr. Reed?
Aye. This commission will stand in recess for 10 minutes.
So Frank Sinatra got his casino license. But the Nevada gaming authorities had called no witnesses to challenge his application.
You think that hearing in Las Vegas was a sham?
Absolutely. Absolutely. And I'm probably foolish for saying so, but I was supposed to appear before that, before them. Their investigators came out to talk to me, and we absolutely refused because there wasn't any question that he was going to get his license.
He likes made guys. He likes to be around them. He likes to have pictures taken with him. You know, Giacana, Lucky Luciano, Fischetti's, you know. Look at all the publicity. He's got Gambino, myself. He thrives on this stuff. I'm telling you, he thrives on it. Of course, he ain't going to tell that to the president. You know, I don't know how he covers that up.